I look at the stars, they asking me what do I see. I noticed that lately all them constellations been looking like me. Inspired to shine, inspired to dream. I think of my life and I feel that I may be as good as I seem. Coming up, I dreamt of the checks I'd be.
Slide, parties in the sky like it's 2055. She said, boy, you nice, heart cold like some water and some ice. Why would you sacrifice knowing you could nobody by your side? I know cap, lie came from dirt, can't go back. You can see it in my eyes. Oh, my kid never tried. All I wanted was some love, trade that for. Big back over down. I don't really want friends, everybody fake. I don't got trust, but I just want.
MP, what's up, bro?
T-Mac, man, what, you here to see me?
Yeah, I'm here to see you. Your agent told me you could use some advice.
Well, yeah, I climbed. All right, so what'd you do to get past that?
Man, I needed to talk to someone.
Now, one of my favorite things about the 2K League is seeing the players' faces realize that their dream is starting in their professional career when they get their name called. What's that like for you on behalf of the 2K League to see these dreams?
With so much of the season still in front of us, Smitty, what does the main focus have to be for a team on any given
substitution?
Changes here for the Heat. Antetokounmpo comes in for Caleb Martin. And it's Oladipo in for Tyler Hero. And the Raptors also making a change. Banton's checked in. So for Toronto right now, inside for him, it's Barnes and Siakam. Then it's Fred VanVleet. Then it's OG Anunoby. And it's Banton in at the two. Siakam passes to VanVleet. Pocket six. Back to Siakam. Over Adebayo. Siakam's shot is off.
Wow, that's one you just kind of assume is going in. Tough luck.
Stolen by VanVleet. Now the Raptors moving it up to end the cold streak, and it's Barnes slamming it down. The
assist. Great anticipation by Fred VanVleet leads to the turnover, which leads to the runout.
Lowry dishes to Antetokounmpo. Lowry kicks to Oladipo. Back to Lowry. To the middle. Antetokounmpo inside. Covered by Barnes, and the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line. A different look for Miami. Dwayne Dedmon's checked in for Adebayo. Max Strus comes in for Butler. And it's Gabe Vincent in for Kyle Lowry. Achiuwa, he's checked in for Toronto. Young comes in for Scotty Barnes.
And winning has become more consistent in Miami than ever. Jimmy Butler was acquired, made it all the way to the finals in his first year, and have steadily won games each season.
Offensive rebound, Young. Some solid defense from Antetokounmpo. Well, it's no secret that MPE was a very controversial pick, Greg, by this team. The debate between him and Shep Owens will be argued for a long time, I'm sure.
And you can see both sides of the argument. A player who does the little things versus an athletic monster with upside. The fan base, though, has made it pretty clear they want it all.
The Raptors making a switch here. Trent's checked in.
One.
The free throw drops for Oladipo. And with the Heat, GA, they've been a consistent force in the Eastern Conference.
Kevin, lots of talent up and down that roster, from stars like Butler and all the way down to the role players. This is just a solid team.
The pass to Trent. Some nice ball movement here by the Raptors. Here's Achiuwa. shooting foul. As the whistle blows, he'll shoot two free throws.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the Heat.
And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Heat.
For me, they made a point to attack inside early in the game, and it's paid off for them. A lot of solid looks in the paint.
And additionally, they're doing a terrific job getting to the line tonight, and they're turning all those trips into early points.
And so Anunoby will bring it up for the Raptors. They trail by 7. The Heat beat them last time when these two teams met down in South Florida.
And it's going to come down to effort tonight. Last time they met each other, they were demolished on the boards, and that rebounding difference led to a sizable loss.
If you don't have that one guy who gets you 10-plus boards every night, you just have to send more guys to the glass.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
And it's finishes like that which have helped them build this lead here in the first half.
Pass to Anunoby. Fires the three. That's good, and he's now 3 for 4 from the field. And so here is Miami. They lead by 4. This game coming on the heels of their win against Toronto.
I like their aggressiveness in that one. No. To go out and take it.
Majority of the night, they were in attack mode. Tremendous effort all the way around.
Passes it to Anunoby. Back to Young. And Young with the stuff.
And you have to credit Anunoby. He's put in the work to become a better playmaker.
Well, he leading by 4. Pass to Vincent. He feeds it to Antetokounmpo. Young with the steal. Anunoby has the open look. A three-pointer off the mark.
There was a mix-up defensively. Left him all alone. He just couldn't hit it.
Antetokounmpo against Young. And that one's good. Antetokounmpo. Antetokounmpo's got 5 points so far.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Here's Banton. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Achiuwa in the corner. 5 on the clock. Here's Banton. Deadman defending. Oh, and he misses the dunk. Miami's gone. Just 1 of 4 from three-point range here in the first. And the shot is good. And now it's an 8-point Heat lead.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Trent outside. There's the pass to Banton. Now, here's Anunoby. Guarded by Oladipo. Now, Achiuwa. For 3. Antetokounmpo pulls it in. And 101 left here in the opening quarter. Oladipo outside. Antetokounmpo finds Struce. Up top, Oladipo. 9 points in the game so far. Down deep, Antetokounmpo. They get the rebound. Back to Oladipo. Fires the 3. That one is good. He's only missed 1 shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
His shot making has been superb this quarter. He's taken over this game.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Looking to end the run. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2.
Clearly a foul.
First trip to the line for him here. And the first one at the line is good. Yurt Zaveni's checked in for Miami. And Toronto also making a switch. Chris Boucher's checked in for Young. Miami leading by 9. 1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. He'll have a jump ball.
Jump ball. Salto.
And here are the Raptors now. Raptors trail by 9. Anunoby passes to Trent. Over to the left wing. Here's Boucher. Sinks that one from the post.
Gary Trent Jr., his teammate, was so open, he could have passed it with his eyes closed.
Victor Oladipo getting it done for the Miami Heat. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here.
Fans, please give a big round of applause.
And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And when you consider how the Heat are doing, guys, what jumps out to you, stats-wise?
Throughout that first, they just were aggressive on the defensive end, showing active hands.
And they took advantage of some careless ball handling, some careless passing. You have to be more careful around these guys.
At the guard spots, Lowry and Hero. Antetokounmpo out there with Butler. And it's Zirtsevin in at the five down low. So that's who Miami starts the second with. That was the 2K drive. As that move deserved another look.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself.
Here's Barnes in the hoop for his fourth field goal. 4 for 7 shooting and looking for more.
Tremendous finisher in close. Scotty Barnes is physical and he's explosive.
Here's Lowry, the kick out to Antetokounmpo. Back to Lowry, down to 5 on the shot clock. The Heat need to get a shot off. Antetokounmpo, no good. And so Van Vliet will bring it up for Toronto. 7-point differential. And Smitty, Fred Van Vliet has really come into his own as a starter.
He has, Kevin. He has proven he can run an offense. He's also a dynamic and confident scorer and someone you can depend on to sink big-time shots. Hero produces across the board. Some guys have potential. Others just get it done.
Barnes passes to Boucher. Siakam left side. The 3. Boucher's shot is off.
Defensively, it's hard to account for everything. They gambled off him, and it worked.
Outside Butler. Banked in off the glass. It's an 11-point Miami lead.
Yeah, that was the third straight high-percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Inside, here's Banton, and it's blocked. Boucher against Butler. Barnes grabs the miss. Raptors trail by 11. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Bangs home the trifecta. Barnes has got 11 points.
Scotty Barnes drilled that jumper off the catch.
Butler kicks to Antetokounmpo. And right away, they match it with a three-pointer of their own. Antetokounmpo's got the lead up to 11 now for the Heat. Toronto, they've gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Banton, the pass to Boucher. A floater. Antetokounmpo pulls it in. Antetokounmpo's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
And that's the battle they haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
He's given a great lift to this offense tonight. Very, very efficient.
And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. On the wing, Barnes. Defended by Butler. Barnes can't get it to go.
I'm not sure what happened on that play. May have relaxed a little bit once he got to the rim.
And out of bounds as Toronto gains possession. And Miami making a change here. Adebayo's checked in. Raptors trail by 13. Siakam deciding where to go with it. They double-team Siakam. And Trent now top of the key. Feeds to Barnes. Over Adebayo. And again, no good by Toronto.
Very surprising. He gets the ball where he wants it in a decent matchup.
And there's another one for the Heat.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Here's Van Vliet. He's now one for two with that bucket.
Improving as a passer. Siakam showing a willingness to get it to open teammates.
Butler kicks to Antetokounmpo. Back to Butler. And it's Antetokounmpo picking up the assist. Antetokounmpo's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Raptors trail by 15. So timeout called here, the first for Toronto. Greg, when you look at Toronto, they have a lot of length and defensive switchability.
They swarm opposing stars and tend to make it very difficult in those passing lanes. For a modern NBA defense.
Siakam finds Van Vliet. Trent outside. Over onto Antetokounmpo. Trent can't hit.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Adebayo with the bucket.
Oh, great feed by Lowry. He'd rather pick up an assist than score a bucket.
Raptors trail by 17. Pass to Siakam. Trent outside. To the inside. Van Vliet. Up and in, off to an efficient start, 2 for 3 from the field.
To counter the size deficiency, Van Vliet has developed an insane number of moves inside.
Lowry passes to Antetokounmpo. Back to Lowry. Shot clock at 5. The feed to Antetokounmpo. And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
Lowry has no problem setting up teammates. He strikes a good balance between passing and scoring.
Van Vliet kicks to Barnes. Passes it to Trent. And it's Young at the elbow. Rebound by Butler.
It can be a little disheartening when you do everything right and come away with nothing.
Van Vliet against Butler. Here's Young. Siakam trying to free himself up. And Young with the basket on the assist from Van Vliet.
As a distributor, Fred Van Vliet is so effective. He knows when and where to feed his guys.
Lowry kicks to Butler. There's the lob into the Kumbo. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. To the paint. Young, good.
Thaddeus Young.
Young's got his third bucket of the night.
Backed by great length, I call Young a reliable interior scoring option.
Outside, out of the Kumbo. He dishes it to Butler. Score that one for him. His eighth field goal. 8 for 11 on a very accurate night.
What a game for him so far. He started out strong in that first quarter and has only turned it up from there.
Young passes to Trent. Back to Young. Poked away and stolen by Butler. Here's Lowry. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. But Van Vliet picks one up.
You love the intensity Kyle Lowry brings. He gives you a no-nonsense mentality at the point guard position.
And the first one drops.
And Smitty, no doubt the veteran Kyle Lowry certainly possesses a lot of that wisdom at this stage of his career.
Greg, he's one of those guys that his teammates respect a proven champion that plays with toughness and intelligence, and a big part of this team.
Here's what Miami's going with right now. Kayla Martin's checked in for Buck, and it's Victor Oladipo in for Hero. With a short break in the action, gives us a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. A busy few years for Nick Nurse. In 2019, he helped lead the Raptors to the title, and he was the 2020 Coach of the Year. He says, it means a lot to me that this city and this country loves this team so much, we can go out there and give them something to be proud of. Of course, Kevin, he's been a key part of that success. Back to you.
Maybe the single most important part of their success, D.A. Thank you so much. Antetokounmpo finds Oladipo. Off target from outside.
And yeah, that old adage about being too wide open, not a thing. He just missed it.
And the way they have controlled the glass this game, really impressive.
You know, you look at how they built this lead. It's been through extra possessions.
And he gets the whistle for the three-second call. And so much great talent coming into the league, Craig, every year. So it's the Miami Heat sitting with a comfortable lead up by 14. They've kept the
Miami Heat 63, the Raptors 49.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this. Antetokounmpo's checked in for Martin. And Toronto has possession. Down by 15. Some nice ball movement here by the Raptors. It's good from Barnes on the assist by Trent. 21 points for Barnes.
Trent Jr.
Efficient performance from him. Not the case for everyone else on his team.
Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
And even down big, the effort and energy is still there to try and make a comeback.
So for Toronto right now, sharing the wing spots for them, it'll be Trent Jr. and Ananobi. Inside for him, it's Barnes and Siakam. And it's Van Vliet in at the point guard position. Pass to Ananobi. To Van Vliet. Bounce pass from Ananobi. And the pass to Trent. Six on the shot clock. Ananobi kicks to Van Vliet. Here's Barnes. Good, and Van Vliet gets the assist. Barnes has got 23.
They're still behind, but not because of his efforts. He's been unbelievable this quarter.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Nice job. Those passes have to be right on the money around the painted area.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for Miami.
They are dominating the paint in this one. Consistent work inside throughout the game.
And we also got to talk about the damage they've done inside. The opposition having a hard time keeping that ball out of the paint.
Here's Trent and the rejection by Antetokounmpo.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today, and there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area. Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Trent outside. Back to Van Vliet. Barnes outside. Here's Siakam. And that's good. A nice job in the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
Look at the effort from Pascal Siakam on the offensive glass. keeping that play alive and finishing it.
And here's Antetokounmpo outside. Good for another basket. He's put up 10 shots and made 7 of them.
He can do incredible things. He can also help you win by simply being reliable.
Trent passes to Van Vliet. Now, here's Anunoby. 11 points in the game. Here's Barnes, and he makes the 8-footer. Barnes has got 25 points in the game.
He has all the tools. Scotty getting things done.
Puts it up for Adebayo. Trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2.
Yeah, the defender all over.
And Scotty Barnes, the rookie of the year in 2022 in the NBA.
And you could argue he was maybe the biggest surprise of the 21 draft. Made a huge impact on the floor immediately. If you did a redraft of that class, he'd be closer to the top.
Catching up on the changes with Miami. Wayne Dedman comes in for Bam Adebayo. And it's Oladipo in for Kyle Lowry. Van Vliet kicks to Siakam. Pass to Barnes. Siakam outside. Down low. Here's Van Vliet. Headshot off. Great D that time from Hero. A Heat leading by 18. He feeds it to Antetokounmpo. And the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
Some shooters get tunnel vision, but Tyler, keeping his eyes up and his options open, delivers a great pass.
Van Vliet kicks to Barnes. Siakam passes to Anunoby. And here is Van Vliet. Good on the triple. Van Vliet's got 7 points in the game.
Well, Fred could do this all day. He's that confident in his long-range shooting.
Back to Hero. Outside, Antetokounmpo for the 3. And the 3 ball is good. Antetokounmpo's got 26.
And the D has gotten a little bit last here, defending the triple.
Van Vliet passes to Siakam. He kicks it to Barnes. 5 to shoot. Offensive rebound. Boucher passes to Barnes. Van Vliet looking around. Goes up again. Van Vliet can't get that one to fall.
And a bump this quarter. He's trying to shoot his way out of it.
Dedman. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And different games, different officials. Something that might be called a foul in one game, Greg, may not be called in the next. As a player, how do you adjust to that?
It's a great question, and that's part of being a veteran. I learned early on, you actually scout officials the same way you scout the players. They have tendencies as well.
Max Strus has checked in for the Heat. Thaddeus Young. He's checked in for Toronto. Anunoby passes to Boucher. Now here's Van Vliet. Toronto working the ball around now. Barnes kicks to Anunoby. Passes to Boucher. Off target from 3-point range.
And this is what you like about his perimeter D. Never gave up and challenged the deep one.
You see some guys, they just mail it in. They don't go out and contest it. Not him. He's going to compete through the entire play.
Van Vliet against Hero. Anunoby in the corner. In the corner, it's Boucher. And again, no good by Toronto. And it's Antetokounmpo with the ball. He'll bring it up for Miami. They lead by 24, their biggest margin. And the call is going to be, yes, yes it is, an illegal screen.
They're doing well overall, but the turnovers have been the exception.
And the replay demonstrating once again how aggressive that defense was.
And guys, that is lockdown defense at its finest, going right at the shot and then able to knock it away.
Ananobi finds Barnes. 1:56 left to play here in the third. Ananobi against Oladipo. And the shot will not go from Ananobi. Miami's gotten the three ball working for them in the second half. They've hit three out of three shots from long range. Here's Antetokounmpo. Boucher with the rebound. Toronto shooting a troubling 38% in the third. Not the finest work of this offense. Dunn trying to break free. Barnes can't get it to go. Miami's gone 6 of 14 with the three ball tonight. Just a little over 40%. Hero passes to Antetokounmpo. Hero kicks to Oladipo. The kick out to Antetokounmpo. Good, and it's Oladipo picking up the assist. 31 points for MP.
And when he gets it going, this is what can happen. They need to think about the double team now.
Here's Boucher. Falls back and frames the fadeaway jumper. Boucher's got 6 points.
When Boucher is on the court, it really helps your spacing. A big who can shoot the rock.
Stolen by Van Vliet. Over in the corner, Barnes. 32 seconds left to play in the third. Pass to Boucher. Fires for three. They get it again. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time. Van Vliet's got 5 points now this quarter. Timeout called, the Heat.
And coach most likely wants to address their turnover issues. The offense looks forced right now. Rush, there's no synergy. They have to find a way to work together and remain aggressive without making mistakes.
Yurt Savini's checked in for the Heat. Caleb Martin comes in. For Max Strus. Achiuwa, he's checked in for Toronto. Hero passes to Antetokounmpo, and he's good on the three ball. Antetokounmpo's got 34 points.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
The dunk by Achiuwa.
Absolutely the prettiest play. In basketball, executed to perfection.
I don't think you'd get an argument there. Everybody loves the alley-oop.
The athleticism plus the mobility. Tyler Hero is someone who drives well inside.
And so it's Miami, ahead by 26 points as we get ready for the break. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. Right back after this break. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, you also have the location of the pass. Puts it right where it needs to be, where his man can do something with it.
Substitution is here for the Heat. Antetokounmpo's checked in for Victor Oladipo. And Strus is subbed in for Gabe Vincent. A new group in now for the Raptors. Siakam is checked in for Achiuwa. Scotty Barnes comes in for Chris Boucher. Ananobi, he's checked in for Porter. And Trent subbed in for Fred VanVleet.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it, just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Heat.
The biggest factor tonight had to be their great shooting. They shot much better than the other team.
Yeah, they were working hard on both sides of the floor, but that sky-high field goal percentage plus the pressure defense to force the other team into a lot of misses. Love the effort tonight.
And every win important in this one will go down as win number three.
And continued dominance against this team, winning both of their matchups this season.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just on a monster game for MP.
Just an outpouring of points from him. Nobody could do much to keep him from dropping it in.
We've got Antetokounmpo. Robinson is out there with Max Strus. Then it's Yurtseven. And it's Jovic in at the small forward. That's the group in the game for the Heat.
OG does a good job of getting ready for catch-and-shoot situations. He knows the value of preparation.
Here's Strus. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Inspired tonight. They fought hard and at crucial points just made the plays.
Especially during this last run, which ultimately put the game away. The thing is, you want to do everything you can.
Let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do.
You got it. You got it. Come on, man.
Right there. You got this. Don't worry.
Get your mind right. Let's get to work. Here's what we're gonna do. Get to work. Here's what we're gonna do. This. Let's go. Thank you. see you want to work on your three-point shooting. Let's get set up.
MP, you got a minute?
Of course, sure.
Look, man, I've been meaning
to... I thought I was clear with you. Basketball comes first. End of story.
It does. But I got a lot of people in my ear telling me I gotta do other stuff too, man.
What, Freddy?
I love that. And one of the things that's so crazy about the 2K League is every season is so exciting as it kind of wraps up. But last year was season 5. I think that 5v5 run was one of the most thrilling runs I've seen in 2K League history. Talk about the level of competition that maybe some of the veterans.
And with every new NBA season, Grant, it's always fun to see which players have a breakout year.
NBA, it seems.
Trailblazers making a switch here. Eubanks has checked in. And Miami with a change here, too. Antetokounmpo's checked in for Oladipo, setting the floor for the Heat. On the wing, it'll be Hero and Butler. MP is out there with Bam Adebayo. And it's Lowry in at the point. Keeps it alive. Great positioning on the putback. Lowry's got 6.
And that's a sign of Kyle Lowry and his competitiveness. You just can't teach that kind of hustle. He anticipated that play.
Simons outside. And here's Lillard. This one for 3. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. And a big question mark for MP that he'll have to answer this year. Can his skills translate into NBA success?
Yeah, he was a great college player. Nobody is arguing that. But many wonder if he'll be able to handle the physical side of the NBA. Hard to say just yet, but we'll find out soon enough.
So Portland going with almost an entire new group here. Watford's checked in for Grant. Little comes in for Hart. Sharp, he's checked in for Simons. And Payton is subbed in for Damian Lillard. Struce, he's checked in for Miami. Vincent comes in for Lowry.
Hard to tell coming out of college what it was that Bam Adebayo was going to hang his hat on offensively. But for sure, you knew relentless effort was going to be part of his game.
more often than not, he'll cash it in from that area. The defense might have done just enough to bother him.
Pass to Antetokounmpo. Rebound by the Trailblazers. They're coming off that loss against Denver.
They just weren't careful with the rock. The passing was loose. The ball handling was lackluster. That's not how you win in this league.
Well, their defense wasn't exactly solid in that game. So if they could make up for mistakes by causing some turnovers, it might have helped. They didn't even get those.
From the arc. That shot is off. And it's Portland the other way. This, their first chance to take a look at the Heat this season.
Interesting East versus West matchup tonight. The first of just two games between these clubs.
Yeah, fun to see maybe strangers because you just aren't familiar with these faces here tonight. This will be a very exciting game to watch.
Yeah, more points coming from inside. In that respect, they've been the more aggressive team.
And Grant, no team better than Miami in developing undrafted prospects.
I mean, for key roles, too. If you look at last year's playoffs, Strus, Martin, Vincent, Robinson, it's allowed Miami to stay on top in a salary cap-driven league.
Here's Vincent. Soft touch off the glass.
Credit their discipline. They've been working for high percentage shots.
And that was the mobile one drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
He made that drive look easy, but that had a high degree of difficulty.
Back to Payton. Passed a little. Here's Payton. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
Second personal foul.
It goes on Bam Adebayo. All right, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Heat?
Well, great play down low. I mean, you expect the defense to adjust, collapse maybe, but that should open up things on the perimeter later in the game.
When you make the most of second chance opportunities, when you're in there and active, boy, that can really put a lot of pressure on the defense.
Deadmonds checked in for Miami. Martin comes in for Butler.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point for them.
Three-pointer sharp. Hits the trifecta. And the Trailblazers lead by two.
And everybody wants to see what kind of range Sharp has. Looks like the NBA three-point line won't be a problem for him.
Martin finds Antetokounmpo. Yep, that one's good.
Both teams are hot. Woo! This is a fun one to watch.
Yeah, made for TV game here. Pace is great. Scoring is coming in bunches. And both of the teams feeling confident right now.
Outside Payton. And he lobs it up to the rim. Out of bounds. It'll be Miami's ball.
That's tough because that one's preventable. The defense has nothing to do at all with that turnover.
Miami has gone 0-for-3 from downtown. To the middle. And he lays in the alley-oop pass.
Oh, what a pass! Those two read each other really well.
Looks like a play they've definitely run in practice. Pass to Little. Back to Payton. Eubanks in the high post.
2 minutes remaining in the first.
Here's Little. Unable to get that one. Good D by Antetokounmpo. Right side Strus. To the inside. And Antetokounmpo with the stuff.
That's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference. Not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
To the paint. Watford gets the bucket.
And you like the balance here. Not just falling in love with the three ball.
Outside Strus. Down low. Here's Antetokounmpo. And Watford pulls it down. Here's Sharp. Covered by Strus. Pass to Watford. Outside Payton. Here's Little. Here's Eubanks. Five to shoot. Back to Little. Beyond the arc. And again, it's the Trailblazers from deep.
Good focus, Nasir, not letting anything distract him from letting that one rip.
Miami trailing. There's 53 seconds left now in the first quarter. Antetokounmpo, right side. From 8 feet. Portland grabs the miss.
Is it getting cold in here? This is a tough one. Crucial that he starts to work a little harder for a higher percentage shot.
Well, Brent Portland has made a name for himself as a perennial contender.
Well, the recent success started with Dame, with the exception of his rookie year. They've made the playoffs every year since, except last year when he was hurt. So Lillard has single-handedly changed Blazers basketball.
Here's Vincent, guarded by Payton. Antetokounmpo outside. Martin outside. They need this. Count it. One for one to start the game.
Of all the action happening there, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
Here's Sharp. And that one is stuffed right through.
Okay, right now, put this kid in the dunk contest. I mean, Sharp can really put on a show. Fun to watch.
And a high-scoring first quarter. Both teams really filling it up. Trailblazers out in front. They lead by a bucket. And we'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. Getting it going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Portland.
Yeah, their early focus on outside scoring has paid off. They're finding plenty of points from three-point land.
They've done a great job tonight of getting out in transition, so that focus on fast break will add to your total in a hurry.
Grant and Nurkic, they're inside at the four and the five. The perimeter filled up by Simons and Hart, and it's Lillard in at the point guard position. That's the group in the game for the Trailblazers. Pass to Simons. Hart against Butler. Outside Hart. Back to Simons. 13 feet out. It's rebounded by Yurtseven.
Probably not the shot that was drawn up for that possession, but you can't pass it up, and you can't knock it down.
Here's Strus. Sends it home from three-point land. Strus has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Outside Hart. Back to Lillard. Pass to Graham. From 13. Good. And it's Lillard who picks up the assist. Grant's gotten his third basket of the night.
Well, all eyes on Lillard defensively, and that causes a big-time breakdown, and he's quick to take advantage.
Lowry, good. And the Heat lead by one. Already seven lead changes. These teams are really going after each other.
It's been a brutal game to play, but a fun one to watch.
Going all in, that was the 2K drive. Well worth a second look.
And I love the way he played downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
The shot by Lillard, no good.
Not sure how he finds himself in so much space there. He's kicking himself for whiffing a bit on that one.
Antetokounmpo, the pass to Butler. And he lobs it up! And it's going to be a three-second call. Tyler Herro's checked in for Miami.
Tyler Herro.
The Trailblazers have gotten 2 of 5 shots to fall this second quarter. Here's Lillard. Portland, no good that time either.
He expects to make every one of those, and we expect him to make them too.
And there's Butler. That one's good. On the assist from Antetokounmpo.
Just a great show of Butler's upper body strength right there as he plays through the contact.
Pass to Simons. Lillard outside. Grant with it. Antetokounmpo covering. Now it's Hart. Back to Grant. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Antetokounmpo has got 4 rebounds now. Here's Herro. Here's your seven. And he battles for the ball, gets his second chance bucket. Now it's a 5-point Miami lead.
Well, he takes care of salvaging that possession for the offense by getting on the offensive glass.
Outside Hart. Inside. And from the field after that one, 3 for 4 now.
Well, weighing around 290 pounds, not sure contact is really going to affect Nurkic. Former first-round pick Josh Hart really trying to get some of his mojo back in terms of shooting the ball from distance. Still scores it with consistency, though.
And why go away from attacking inside if the D has no answer for you?
Outside Hart. Pass to Simons. Now Nurkic, and he finishes. That makes him 4 out of 5. And with Josh Hart, Brent, really able to stretch the floor for these guys.
Well, playing the 2 and the 3, maybe a little undersized, but took more three-pointers last year, trying to gain some confidence there. Man, if he's at 35-36%, that's going to open a lot for him and his team. Not his best night from the field, but looking for other ways and finding them so he can chip in.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
Pass to your 7. Down low. Here's Antetokounmpo. Portland grabs the miss. They'll be playing host to Houston for their next game, and they'll be reaching the back half of a 4-game home stretch. And here's Grant from the arc. It's rebounded by your 7. Your 7's got 4 rebounds now.
This has been a close game in a lot of ways, but they do have an edge on the boards. You just can't give up looks that close to the rim.
Portland has gone 0 for 3 from deep to begin the second. And here's Lillard from beyond the arc. Antetokounmpo grabs the board. Antetokounmpo's got his 5th rebound in this one.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Portland calls timeout. You know, Grant, sometimes with certain flagrant fouls, you'll hear people say it was a dirty play, but not a dirty player. But when does it become both?
Well, we all understand, B.A., dirty plays aren't good for the game. But sometimes a flagrant foul will happen. A lot of times, though, you have to factor in a pattern of behavior. I really believe players who have a history of being called for a lot of flagrant fouls plays a big role in how it's perceived.
Adebayo's checked in for Miami. Oladipo comes in for Jimmy Butler. Hits a 3-pointer.
Zero hesitation out there as he catches that pass. Lillard just fires it.
Oladipo, the pass to Hero. Lillard against Lowry. And that one falls. His 5th basket in 7 tries.
And guys, the way this defense is getting manhandled down low, you have to wonder if they're at 100% right now.
And here's Lillard from beyond the arc. Rebound by the Heat. Antetokounmpo has got his 6th rebound on the night. Lowry outside. Simons against Hero. And again, it's Miami converting.
That's just tremendous scoring instinct. So fun to watch him work in the half court.
Simons outside. Hard against Oladipo. Outside Hart. Back to Simons. Stolen by Hero. Here's Oladipo. Again, the Heat score.
Oh, yeah, and if you didn't think Oladipo could fill the lane in transition, he answered your questions there.
Lillard against Lowry. Lillard passes to Simons. Shoots over Hero. Again, the miss by the Trailblazers.
Their strong work ethic has been evident on the glass, really getting after it and being physical.
And Adebayo slams it in.
Hero, knowing a about the whens and the wheres for an assist.
Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Well, guys, Jimmy Butler's focus is all on team success. In fact, his agent said whenever he calls Jimmy to congratulate him on personal accolades, like All-NBA team, for example, Jimmy hangs up in his face before he can finish the sentence. Brian, for Butler, there's only one prize that really matters.
Yeah, he's a rare breed, Allie, for sure. Thanks for that.
Time for some consideration in the passing category, maybe, Kevin. The shot is just not on. Get somebody else going.
Lillard against Lowry. Antetokounmpo outside. And that comes off the assist by Lowry. Lowry's got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Portland has gone just 1 of 6 from the perimeter here in the second. And the Trailblazers call time here.
And year in and year out, there's one thing we know for certain about the Blazers. They've got some of the best fans in the NBA.
It's dance time in Portland. Here are your Blazer dancers.
A big group substitution here for Portland. Watford's checked in for Grant. Little comes in for Hart. Sharp, he's checked in for Simons. And Payton is subbed in for Lillard. And Miami with a change here, too. Vincent's checked in. Here's Watford. Antetokounmpo covering. The shot by Watford, no good. And how about the fan base in Portland? They're passionate, and they really understand the game.
That's so true, B.A. I mean, even in lean years, they come out to support their club. And when they're on top, all of Rip City gets caught up in the buzz. Portland's a great basketball town.
Oladipo, the pass to Antetokounmpo. Goes back up. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
I don't mind that. I mean, they met him at the rim and temporarily prevented the points.
Now, Britton, you look at Miami's playoff pedigree. They've made the Eastern Conference Finals 6 times over the last 12 years.
Yeah, and those 2 championships they had in that 12-year period were square on the shoulders of their big three that they put together. But I don't see them slowing down when it comes to reloading. This team knows how to do it well.
Martin, he's checked in for Vincent.
All the rumors swirling about the Blazers and whether they trade Damian Lillard or not, but they've decided to keep him in Portland, build around him, and try to make the most of this shining star's window.
Pass to Sharp. Over Oladipo. Again, the miss by the Trailblazers.
And they're up considerably because of their efforts on the glass.
Here's Martin. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
Personal foul.
Right, and when the Blazers shook things up, many thought they'd do a full rebuild, Brent.
Yeah, but B.A., how do you give full value for a guy like Damian Lillard? I just don't think the return coming back would equate to that. So they've reworked the roster. And we'll see if these guys can get back to postseason play and then rely on Dame time.
Both good from the line that time.
Yeah, they're really cashing in more at the line here in the second quarter.
Portland has gone just 1 of 6 from the perimeter here in the second. Time called here. The Trailblazers decide to talk it over.
Oh, my. Their coach does not look happy, and I can guess why. Their interior defense has been struggling.
No, they're not preventing them from scoring, and if you can get to a high-efficiency shot on the floor, and that's the paint, you just keep going.
Here's Sharp. He's guarded by Oladipo. Here's Watford, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Oh, and that's a nice find by one of the youngest players in the league. Sharp with tremendous upside to his game.
Antetokounmpo outside. Knocks it down from distance. Antetokounmpo's got 12 now in this quarter.
Defense shaking their heads. No idea how to stop him in this quarter. He's got him on the ropes.
Pass to Nurkic. And he drains it. A solid 5 for 6 now.
Maybe he's thinking at this point, man, somebody's got to help me. I can't do this all by myself.
Hero against Payton. Hero, the pass to Antetokounmpo. Oladipo outside.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Three-pointer off the mark. The Trailblazers shooting around 50% of the game so far. Pass to Nurkic. Parked it down low that time. Got hit with the 3-second call.
Ooh, talk about a way to deflate the team.
Yeah, he knows he shouldn't have made it, and that's just really overall a frustrating sequence that hopefully doesn't stick with him.
Simons has checked in for Sharp, and Miami with a change here, too. Deadman's checked in for Adebayo. Hero finds Antetokounmpo. And he gets it to go. Antetokounmpo's got 20 points.
I'll tell you what, they are on fire this quarter, taking total command of this game.
Outside Payton, shoots over Hero. Payton, no good. Miami has gone 3 of 4 from outside so far in the second quarter. Payton against Hero. Antetokounmpo outside. With nobody on him, he buries that jumper. He's got 22.
Just how awesome is it to watch the best of the best start to dominate in a game?
Back to Simons. 51 seconds left in the first half of this game.
Great contest down low. Allowing no easy hoops is a winning approach.
Hero. And good. Coming on the setup by Oladipo. Oladipo's got 3 assists tonight.
Hero sticking with it through contact. That's not easy.
And it's flushed down. A nice jam.
Leaping ability is off the charts. Not the biggest power forward, but outstanding at rising up off the ground.
Hero against Payton. And Antetokounmpo with the stuff.
Tyler Hero.
Give their offense some love. They've been the more efficient team.
Yeah, that along with maintaining the pace of play. Right now playing with tons of intensity.
Watford gets the bucket.
Brendan Watford.
There's 18 seconds left to play in the first half of basketball. Now here's Hero. He has 6. And so it's the Miami Heat up 19 points as the quarter comes to a close. They've kept their concentration on limiting Damian Lillard, and it's been working. Time for a quick break. Then back to the action. As we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it's been a runaway. And Portland's shooting around 50% in the game so far, setting the floor for Miami. Oladipo and Butler, your small and power forwards. Kyle Lowry out there with MP. And it's Adebayo in at the 5, down low. Antetokounmpo against Nurkic. Ooh, good work defensively by Butler.
Despite the miss, those are the kind of looks coaches hope to create. And Jusuf Nurkić, a solid role player, fits well into any team environment. A great passer and doesn't need touches to contribute.
Lillard passes to Simons. A shot from the mid-range. He can't hit that time. And Miami will go the other way with it. And we saw last year, Nurkic can also act as a mentor with young players, Grant.
Yeah, B.A., and that's a great veteran presence from Nurkic. Not a star player by any means, but a player everyone would want on their team.
And kind of par for the course here, right? Coming through with a solid offensive game to help them get this lead.
Nurkic passes to Simons. No good. Great D that time from Antetokounmpo.
Coming out stone cold here. Sometimes the break will do that to you.
To the paint. And the jam by Antetokounmpo.
Well, part of the game plan was to neutralize the crowd. And guess what? Mission accomplished.
Always a good sign of maturity and steps forward when you can take this kind of effort, focus, and concentration on the road to get a win.
Grant finds Simons to stop the run. Miami grabs the miss.
Well, his poor shooting is a big reason that they're staring at this deficit right now. He needs to get on track if they're going to find a way to win.
Lowry against Lillard. Here's Antetokounmpo. That's good. And so Lowry with the assist. Antetokounmpo's got 7 now in this quarter. Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Yeah, and that's a little icing on the cake right there. Putting on a show while they enjoy a big second half lead.
Here's Simons. Portland, no good that time either.
You kind of wonder where his head's at. The shot selection hasn't been there. And of course, that one was just crazy.
Think about well-constructed teams and themes that go with that. The Miami Heat certainly leap to mind. Their front office has just done a great job of assembling a deep roster that fits their mentality.
Well, you would know the depth of the Miami bench is certainly felt in the strength of their second unit.
Yeah, when the starters sit down, Miami doesn't lose much. There's a tremendous combination of skill and playability that they lean on throughout the course of the regular season, and the bench certainly makes big contributions with their minutes.
Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Timeout called, Portland.
And the other team is running all over them right now.
The timeout before the timeout here, maybe just to cut off the momentum and have a chit-chat with the team to settle down.
The Heat making a switch here. All right, guys, some stats here. The scoring breakdown for the Heat.
Well, they found success off the drop, creating a lot of buckets by getting into the teeth of the defense.
All game long, they've just done a great job of keeping the pressure on the defense and penetrating with the pass. They've gotten everything inside, and they've converted there.
All right, Brent, how about what Tyler Hero brings to the table?
Well, Tyler is such a huge part of why the Heat had so much success last season, coming off the bench with unbelievable consistency, and he shot the three as good as ever, raised that scoring average up. This guy is not an all-star yet, but he's on the fringe, BA.
Just 5 to shoot. Here's Little. Portland again missing.
Yeah, no, he usually makes you pay from that range.
To the inside. Here's Antetokounmpo. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Antetokounmpo's got 35 in the game.
He's played a huge role in this game to this point, but it looks like he just wants more. He wants to make sure that this lead holds up.
Here's Little. He's got 5. On the wing, Payton. Martin against Hart to end the drought. And it's Miami with a rebound. Antetokounmpo's got 13 rebounds in the game. Glass eating. To the middle. Here's Dedmon. Good. And Antetokounmpo gets the assist. Antetokounmpo's got 3 assists now in this one.
2 minutes remaining in the third.
Outside Payton. Pass to Eubanks. Lillard outside. It's Hart on the wing. Puts it up. Some solid defense from Martin.
He's been off the mark, and that hasn't helped them chip away at the lead. It's been a theme here this quarter.
Antetokounmpo, the pass to Dedmon. Boom! He jams it straight down.
They're really dictating the tempo on both ends of the court. You love it.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
Lillard outside. Down low. Here's Little. Over on Antetokounmpo. Oh, sinks it after the cagey pump fake. Nice. Little's got 7 points.
Making the effort to get himself a high percentage opportunity. And Nasir Little just aggressive.
Pass to Martin. Now here's Antetokounmpo. The 3-pointer off the mark. There's 47 seconds left in the third. Here's Payton. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. It's on Tyler Hero. And the Blazers have been a mainstay in the playoffs for so long. Up until last year.
Yeah, B.A., they ended an 8-year streak by missing the playoffs. The franchise has had a lot of sustained success. They missed the playoffs just 15 times in their 50-plus years.
Sharp, he's checked in for Portland.
And he lobs it up top!
Well, Lowry Dwayne sees the breakdown, and then he knows the guy's going to be open. What a delivery that was. Lowry.
Payton with it. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Hart. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
First that one on Martin. Foul. Third team foul. At the
first
line
one falls for the
Blazers. Josh Hart at the line for two.
He does not get the second one. Well, the Heat shooting a remarkable 60% clip. Very efficient. Lowry, the pass to Antetokounmpo. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
Penalty.
And that one falls for Antetokounmpo.
And really strong at the line since the break.
And it's the Blazers with the ball. Outside Payton. Pass to Hart. The shot off that time. And as we conclude the third, pretty much a blowout here. It's been a one-sided affair. Heat out in front, running away with this one. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter when we return. And meanwhile, Eric Spoelstra rallying the troops.
I like the activity, guys. Active hands.
So, no problem for Miami as they get the win. To walk into enemy territory and deliver a performance like that, that says a lot about this squad.
They really came in looking confident and didn't let anything shake them. This is what a dominant team looks like.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Ali LaForce, Grant Hill, and Brent Berry, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching tonight's game. We'll see you later.
Great game tonight. You guys really dominated on offense, and you in particular couldn't miss. What was the key to your performance tonight?
Oh, man. I think you saw tonight what this team is capable of when we all play together. Man, when we look to take that extra pass, we a hard team to defend.
Well, you were having a lot of success individually.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see something in their defense?
You know, man, I think it's just my teammates looking for me to get the ball in places where I can convert, you know? Nothing too crazy.
Right on. Thank you, man.
No doubt.
What do you say to the people who question the wisdom of your decision to participate in a PR offensive to win over the hearts and minds of the city?
I'd say they probably don't know me very well, or what I'm all about.
Okay, what are you all about?
Lifting up those around me, Nate. Are you not listening? I mean, on the court and off the court. I've been doing that since day one. But in a new city with a new fan base, I needed a little help getting started, you know? So I got together with the team and with the organization, and we talked about how I could make a difference within the community. You got something against making the community better? Because it seems like it.
Wait, me?
Yeah, you.
Not at all. I mean, I just think some people see all this as like a like a distraction.
Well, that's too bad, because it's not. There's 24 hours in a day, so there's plenty of time for me to work on my craft and be a helpful member of society. I think if you ask anyone in that locker room, they'll tell you that I put in just as much work as anybody when it comes to ball. So no, I don't see it as a distraction.
I mean, could be seen as a little cynical, but I mean, something maybe to help the
Listen
team
here,
sell
Nate,
merchandise.
I think I covered this topic adequately. I'm here to play ball and help my community. There's nothing to it beyond that.
All right. Thanks for your time, bro.
Thank you.
I was wondering if I could ask you about Nate White's report that you've been asked to participate in PR initiatives by the team.
Yeah, sure.
Well, I think it sounds like a really cool idea, and I'm wondering if you can talk about maybe some of the things you might be doing or some of the things you might be looking forward to.
Well, John, I'd like to actually clarify things a little further.
Sure. That's why we're here.
Great. So, look, this organization, one of the great things about it is they...
I look at the stars, they asking me what do I see? I noticed that lately all them constellations been looking like me. Inspired to shine, inspired to dream. I think of my life and I feel that I may be as good as I seem. Coming up, I dreamt of the checks, I be running up. I sat on my bed writing lyrics and songs. I would practice them all, but it wasn't enough. I want to perform, I want a crowd. Singing it back to me, stadium loud. Homies in front turning up, getting down. I'm proud. The energy hit when the lights on. That energy hit when it's my song. I'm starting to think like a mogul. I'm starting to feel like an icon. Cause I ain't the same and I know it. But I got the heart of a poet. That money is good, but it's new here. I'm trying so hard not to blow it. Cause all of my friends walk around and they icy, pricey. But when it come to me, I prefer just a tee and some Nikes. I might be running from changes. I like how it is. Easy to cover the life that I live. Still ain't got used to the sight from the crib. I knew I would have it when I was a kid. At moments, the nights will be dark. Won't hold you, the journey was long. Through all of the imagine the younger me singing a song, yeah. Like Hickory Dickory, my clock has been ticking to victory. I don't have a fear in the world. Whenever it's time, I know they'll be listening.
Hickory Dickory dog, the biblical dog.
If I want to think, then I know that I gotta get the rock. Gotta go harder with every drop. I be remembered like Biggie and Pac. That be the reason I stay on my grind. I ain't wasting no time when I'm racing the clock, yeah.
Hickory Dickory dog.
If I can see them as a link, then I know that I gotta behave as the watch. Crank it up if only by a notch. Master the art and then give them a swatch. Put everything that I got on the line, I ain't wasting no time.